Before we begin, just a quick note to remind you that Mythic Battles rules are in beta and in flux. So if you have questions, queries, or not sure about that moments, come on over to beastsofwar.com to this post, leave your feedback, and the developers will be watching. Enjoy the game.
Fight for the Iron Kingdoms as a warcaster. Take control of the mighty jacks, arcane devices, and dark sorceries to bring the fight to the War Machine Hub on beastsofwar.com. Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastsofwar.com.
Hi everybody, welcome to another Let's Play Mythic Battles Pantheon. I am of course joined by the fabulous Leo. Today we're playing a scenario, yes?
Yes, so that's a very different way of playing the game. Mm-hmm. We've seen a lot of
skirmishes
and, yes, and different modes, but we have lots of scenarios in this game. Mm-hmm. Actually, when we deliver the game, if you add up all of the scenarios that we have for the game, that includes the ones in the compendium, which is the campaign book, the ones from the different, the three different expansions, or the ones from the smaller expansions, and the one in the core box. If you add up all of them, you have 76 scenarios.
You guys really went overboard with this game, I have to say. It's fantastic.
76 scenarios. And this is just one of these 76 scenarios that will allow you to see what a scenario is, and you will see that it's a very different way of playing.
Okay, well, can you give me a brief idea of what we're going to be doing in this scenario? Because we're about to draft. As you can see, we have all the stat cards laid out on the table here. So if I have a brief overview of what we're trying to achieve, that way I can sort of tailor my force a little bit.
Okay, this scenario comes from one campaign. It's not even the first scenario, but like in most scenarios from the campaign, you can always just pick one and just play it without playing the campaign. So this one is comes from the compendium. And in this campaign, you have two sides that will have several gods united. So several gods united on one side and several gods united on the other side, right? And as you play the game, you will recruit some different units. And each scenario has an impact on the next one. So if a god dies, for instance, either you can't recruit him or you can't recruit him for the next scenario until he feels better. He's not really dead or something like that, right?
Cool.
This particular scenario takes place in the Styx map. The Styx, you know, is where the underworld, the entrance of the underworld.
Yes, and the river of the dead.
Yes, the river of the dead. Mm-hmm. We're going to play there. And in this scenario, the dead will make the river grow and flood, right? So as we kill, or as we kill, or some people are killed, you will be able to place some markers, some swamp markers, that will, and if that will cause problem the way we move. And if you have two of them, right, you receive some wounds. So, and in this scenario, the victory conditions are completely different. What we need to do is we need to score points, and you score points by eliminating some enemy units, right?
Right.
The ones with the most score points at the end wins the scenario.
Right.
So we are in the Styx, which is a map that has many zones, many areas, and that, and it's not easy to move through it. It takes longer, right? You have the Styx River itself when you're in it.
Yes.
You have no powers, no talents.
Oh.
Okay.
That has caught my interest.
Yes. You have the rifts. The rifts only heroes can get in the rifts. Monsters have to jump over them, like you jumped over lava, right?
Yes.
So, but human sized, so heroes and troops can get in the rifts, and that allows you to move faster. So this is another thing that you need to know while we are going to draft here.
Okay.
Okay? So it will take longer before you reach your opponent in this map, and human-sized creatures could go faster than big monsters.
But if you're taking human-sized creatures, they're maybe a little weaker, so you'll maybe die faster.
Maybe a balance or something.
Yeah, this is going to make for an interesting scrap. All right, well, let's begin the draft, eh?
Sure.
So, as always, we roll. So, for myself, I get 2.
I got 0.
Lovely. So, I get to pick first.
So, we have 18 points of draft, right? Including the gods who cost 6.
Mm-hmm. And Hera. The god who costs 4.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So, I have 1, so I get first pick. Yes?
And you must choose your god first.
Yes. Well, I tell you what. See, I keep looking at Ares, but I don't want to just keep playing the same game over and over again. So I'm actually going to take Zeus, because Zeus is a very, very strong character and is one of the best that you can play. And I think having, you know, him being able to cast lightning and stuff around the table, if I maybe get a shot on something that's a little weaker, I can maybe knock it out a little easier with him having the best shooting in the game, essentially. So that's number one for me. Who will you take?
Okay, well, if you play the campaign, there are 2 sides. So maybe I couldn't pick a god who's in your side. But in this scenario, we are free to choose anything, right? So I'm saying this because I'm really tempted to take one of my favorite, who's Athena.
Yes.
Because I believe in this game, it could be useful to activate several times. Mm. Although she's not as resistant as Zeus, sorry. Mm-hmm. So it's a little dangerous, but I still want to have her. Okay. And because I got second draft.
Yes, you get the first pick of heroes, monsters, and troops.
Yes.
Any thoughts?
I will go for Leonidas.
Leonidas, where is... he is here. So, Leonidas, leader of the Brave 300, and an absolute badass whenever it's coming to this game, because he's a little trickier to use. I keep looking at him and I think, I want to try him, but he's a little tricky. So, my turn then, yeah? Oh, how many points do we have?
12.
12, that's not including your
18,
god.
18, yeah, okay. 18 including the...
Okay, so I've spent 6 on my god.
And I've spent 9 altogether.
Just because you've left me the opportunity, I am going to take Odysseus, just because he's so efficient, and he's going to generate me an additional 3 Art of War cards, which is very, very good for a human.
I will choose the centaur.
The centaurs, who are over here, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's 1 point, so...
Alright.
I've spent...
10.
10.
Yep. I'm currently on 9 as well. Honestly, I'm going to be taking quality over quantity here. So I'm going to take one of the toughest characters in the game, who will also be able to go through the rifts, which is Achilles.
Oh.
That brings me to 13. Out of my 18, leaving me a 5. Yes?
Yes.
Awesome.
I'm going to pick this guy.
Okay.
Haven't played him yet. I want to see how
he does. Is this one of the death judges?
Yes.
Okay.
Judge of the dead.
Yeah. Is there anything you can throw about on this map? Are there ruins and stuff on it?
No, there are no...
No ruins, no trees?
No, no ruins, no trees.
Okay, now I had considered Heracles there for a heartbeat, but if one of his abilities is completely nullified on this map, he's maybe not so useful. Yes, he's still a good, big, beefy fighter, but no. What I need is a decent guard. And I think the Nemean lion has guard, yes?
He doesn't have guard.
He doesn't?
No.
No. Then it will have to be Cerberus, the guard dog.
Oh, yes, he does.
Which leaves me with 1 point left. So, Cerberus, as you can see, has the guard ability, mighty throw ability, and block. So, very, very good defensive creature. But he's a big creature, so I may not be able to move him too well on this map.
I wanted, you know, I'm thinking because I wanted to take Atalanta because she's small and she can Well, she moves two, so she could be really, really, really fast in the rifts.
Yeah.
But then it would only, well, then I would have. I would have 3 points left, and I would need to take 1 3-point monster, and wouldn't be able to use much of Leonidas'
abilities. Yeah,
with his troops, and if I don't take her, that means I need to take 3 troops, which possibly could be a bit too much.
This is the balancing act.
I'm going to take another Judge of the Dead. Okay. He's a hero, so he's small. He can go in the rifts. And he's 3 points.
Okay.
I'll take Ickes.
Okay.
He's a guard, too, and I like that.
Yeah. For my last pick, I'm going to go with the Hellhounds. They're small, they're fast, and I don't really mind if they, you know, get into trouble. I will literally abandon them. So that leaves you with your 2 points.
With my 2 points, well, the setters are fast, right? They move two and they're small. So that's my first, and then my second.
Yep, because I'm out of points now.
Probably take the Hell Warriors because they regenerate and. This could allow, well, prevent you from scoring points by eliminating them. If they come back, they regenerate, it'll, they will be harder, a little harder to kill. Or the Spartans, because the Spartans are very resilient. I'll go for the Hell Warriors.
Okay. All right, well, that is our draft complete.
Yes.
We'll move on here and we will get the gaming table set up. Okay, everybody, we have done the draft. We have got the gaming table set up. This time, we are playing on the River Styx. So this will be interesting because this is a map I've not played on before. And as soon as you change the maps in this game, everything really, really just changes up. You really have to think about what you're up to. So, Leo, with me having won the draft, I assume I get to draw first, yeah?
Yes, absolutely. Okay, let me tell you about the map, right?
Yep. Are there any special rules I need to know about?
Yes, there are special rules.
Okay.
So this is the River Styx map. So this one is in the core box. And it's the entrance to the river that brings
to the underworld, yes.
Yes, the underworld. So you can see there are a few areas that you have to know about. These are cliffs. These are impenetrable terrain. Only if you have a flying unit can you go here, right?
Okay.
These are stairs, so no problem. These are areas that can receive ruins, but there are no terrain in this scenario.
Yes, hence Heracles is at home.
Yes, exactly. And the two remarkable things are the river, the Styx River, and the rifts. Yes. These are, well, these here, here, and here, this is the Styx River, right? And these little creeks here, those are called the rifts, right? So, if you look at this area compared to some others, it takes longer to go from one place to the other. It's
very broken up ground.
Absolutely, yes. But the small units, small-sized units, like heroes or troops.
All right, well, let me put one on the table just for demonstration. Okay, so there's Achilles.
Yes, Achilles can go in the rift. And then, as you see, the areas are very broad. So with one movement, he can go from here to here.
Ah.
It's much faster. Well, if it was Cerberus, if he wanted to go, well, here, it would take him, or even here.
Yeah.
It would take him one, two, then he can't enter the rift. He has to spend one movement to get there. So three, four. So you see.
He has to jump. Okay.
Yes, he had to jump. Well, a big creature who wants to go over the rift has to spend one extra point. It cannot stay on the rift.
Right, it's too big.
Yes, it's too big.
Okay.
And when you are on the rift, you don't block line of sight because you're...
You're essentially down in a crevasse.
Exactly.
Okay.
Just down up the crevasse.
Okay. Now, you had also mentioned something about abilities and stuff. Do I lose those whenever I'm in there?
You lose your talent and powers when you're in the Styx River.
Okay.
Not in the rift.
Okay.
But you will see that there are some other rules for this scenario.
Okay, well, I assume we're looking at two single zone deployments because I have a red chit here and there's one here on the table.
That's
and you have the
blue. Right. Yes, yes. Because you won
the draft.
Yes. I chose the deployment, so I chose to deploy here and you're going to deploy over there.
Okay, well, I will draw my cards and I have my 3 out of 4 cards to begin with.
And now I have to tell you the special rules for this game.
Yeah.
And the scenario. Okay, so in these scenarios, the water, the Styx River is going to
rise.
To rise,
yes, yes,
because of all the killing and stuff.
Yeah.
And this will become a dangerous situation.
Right.
So, what we have to do is we have to score, would you say, prestige points or
if it's for killing units, it's just kill points.
We could say kill points.
Okay.
How do you make them? Well, when you destroy a unit, you score as many points as their recruitment cost.
See.
Gods only give you four points, right? The first one of us who scores 8 points wins the game.
Okay.
But there are some other little things happening. Every time you inflict 2 wounds, the river, well, there's blood coming, and then the river will rise. So you have to put a token, a swamp token. Where can you put it? You can put it in any areas like the river here. So there's a special rule with the swamp tokens, right? These three areas are considered swamp. Mm-hmm. So when you're in the swamp, unless you're an aquatic unit, you can only move one.
Right? So you're slowed down.
Yes, cool. So you're slowed down. And the ranged attack against you are +1. Mm. Okay? In the rift, right now, there's not enough water, so you don't have this problem. But you will be able to place some swamp tokens every time you inflict 2 wounds to an enemy. And you place it either in a swamp area.
Yeah.
So swamp areas can only receive one of these, and you will see what they do. In the rift, anywhere on the rift, or in an area adjacent to either a swamp or an area containing a swamp token. So I could put it here, if there's one here, right? So if a unit is in a rift with one swamp token at the beginning of their turn, they automatically lose one wound. Ooh. Well, they get one wound.
Okay.
In a normal area, you need to have 2 tokens to do this, right? But it's already considered a swamp when you're here. Here, you only need one because it's already a swamp, right? Okay.
Interesting.
So you will see.
This is going to be a very different way to play because I'm seeing no Omphalos on the table.
No.
At all. So I'm guessing they're just not here.
Yes.
Okay.
An important rule also. You can recall your troops. Well, your dogs, your hounds.
Yep. I specifically chose them because I didn't want something that was quickly going to die and just take over victory points.
But that's good.
That's my tactical thought.
If you recall them,
yes,
and there is at least one left, hound left, right? Yep. I will make one victory point, right?
So,
or kill point, right? So we start with 0.
Yes.
Every time we score, let's say 2 points because I killed a 3 points because I killed a 3 points unit, I will put it on here.
Yes.
First one who reaches 8 wins the game.
Gotcha.
If at any time, except for the first turn, at the end of my turn, there's none of your unit on the map.
Yes.
I automatically win one victory point. Okay. So that means you can't just hold up.
Yeah, it forces me to get onto the table and get going.
Yes.
All right. Well, speaking of getting going, let's.
And then there's the last rules, special rules.
Yep. There are more.
Okay. Yes, there. Yes, three more.
Okay.
There are different ways to use the Art of War cards. Okay. You have the normal ways, uh-huh. and then you can do during your turn any of these Art of War card effect.
Yep.
You pick one. You can only have one of these three per turn. Mm-hmm. The first one is you spend an Art of War card, and you can put this anywhere. Mm. So you could put it somewhere on your opponent so that he will lose a wound
the
next time, right? You can, with one Art of War card, you can take out one of these tokens, mm-hmm. right? Okay,
for
one Art of War card. And the last effect is before you make an attack, you spend on one Art of War card, and you can add a bonus of three to your attack.
So three dice?
Three dice.
Okay, that's going to be useful. Okay. Right, well, the first thing I'm going to do is, I'm going to spend an Art of War card to draw two.
Oh, did you first draw your card?
No, I did not. So I get one. And then I will draw 1, 2, because that's what I'm doing. Okay, this is fabulous. So, I will play Achilles and bring him directly onto the table. So, I will place him in here. And I'm guessing complicated action to come onto the battlefield,
absolutely.
As always.
Yes.
So, that'll be him. Onto you.
Okay, my turn.
Yep.
I'm going to play minus.
Okay.
And I'm going to put him here.
Right.
So let me just give you, because it's the first time we see him.
Yes.
Just a little description.
Yes.
He's a 3-point monster. So if you kill him, you'll score three
victory. Points. Yeah.
Yes. He has the Force of Nature talent that you haven't seen yet. He could use a ruin or a tree, and he doesn't throw it as far as Heracles, but it's
he can
still,
throw them.
Yes.
Okay,
but
cool.
It won't be useful here.
Yep.
He has the mighty throw talent that
of course.
You know, and he's a leader. So if he ends up his activation in an area, a troop area, I can go pick up the card and activate it
without an
Art of War card.
Okay,
all right?
Useful.
And then two powers. When a friendly unit, means one unit from my side, is attacked, he can choose to change the target to another friendly unit within the attacker's range. So let's say you attack Athena.
Uh-huh.
I can say...
No, I'll have it on... The Hell Judge,
yes.
The Hell Guard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are the
okay.
Hell Warriors, yes.
They have to be in range, right?
Yeah.
But this costs me one Art of War card.
Yeah, but it's nice because it sort of means that you can sort of pass out guard to any unit you want.
Yes.
So
for one
useful.
Art of War card.
Mm-hmm.
And it has to be in range, in the attacker's range,
yes.
right?
Yes.
And then the second thing, which doesn't cost me anything and it's important to see. Let me show you so that you know. Okay, I'm here, it's my turn,
yes.
I get here, and the tribute of a minus, at the end of my activation, I can kill one enemy automatically. Just troops. So I can immediately, I will eat them.
Eat the dogs.
Yes,
okay.
And I will regain one vitality.
I'm glad I didn't take a lot of troops.
Okay, well that's it.
Okay.
So he's here.
Uh-huh.
I've played him. Do I? Well, I'm going to right now to
save the power.
Yes,
okay.
My Art of War cards.
So I'll draw. All right. I will deploy Cerberus.
Okay.
You know, he's coming home. He hears the whistle. Come on, boy. Time for dinner. So he will deploy into here. I know he's hanging off, but we all know he's in the proper zone here. That will do me. Or will it? No, I'm actually going to spend one Art of War card, and I will deploy Zeus onto the battlefield, because why be subtle? The big guy's there, ready to rock and roll. Now, I know my guys are a little bunched up at the minute, but because Leo is so far away, I don't think he can get to me too quickly, unless he uses those passageways. Nice. So, your turn.
Draw a card.
Yep.
I will deploy Athena.
Okay. Anyone else?
No.
No? Okay. So it's back to me. Right. I'm going to have Achilles activate. And Achilles will run. And Achilles will run one into the crevices. And then two, which will put him into this one.
So he's moved much faster than
he's
he would.
Much faster, because right now he can next turn come out either here or here.
Yeah.
So he's about halfway up the table, whereas otherwise it would just take him turn after turn after turn. But see, the good thing is I can advance and retreat up and down those, so I'm not overextending myself as much. So, yours, Leo.
Yes, I could attack you in the rift, but you're Achilles.
Unchilles.
Well, but I can use an Art of War card to boost my attack.
Ah, oh yeah. Uh-oh. Well, still, Achilles has defense of 9. What's the attack on minus?
6.
So, 9 to 9, you'll take a lump out of him.
Yeah. And then you could counterattack me.
And Achilles on the counterattack is ferocious.
Let's bring the satyrs here. Mm-hmm. And not rushing myself, but that was tempting.
Yes.
By the way, the maximum dice you can roll is 10.
10. Okay, so there's no point really spending that on Achilles, because that would bring him to the 10, because he's on...
Well, no, yes.
Or no, actually, yes. Yeah, we'll bring him to the full 10.
But for Zeus, you would only gain one dice, right? Is it 9? Two dice.
Two dice you would get. Yeah, okay. And his defense is 9.
Okay.
Done? Okay. I draw. Aha. All right, let's slow the pace of the game down slightly. I'm going to bring in the dogs. So the Hellhounds will come into this zone here. Shoot everything across just so I have space to get them properly on. Here. Here. And here. That'll do. That will do me.
Okay. Let me draw a card. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, let's take my time. I'm bringing Icus, who has the god ability. Mm-hmm. Who can exile you.
Yes.
To your deployment area for one Art of War card.
Mm-hmm. Is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Alright, let's get Cerberus a bit further up the field.
Mm-hmm.
So Cerberus has a standard move of 2. So I can go 1, 2.
Wait. You have to cross.
Ah, I didn't see there's a river here. So that would be 1, 2, yes. And then a run for 3.
Yes.
So that'll do nothing else. Except for, you know, stand there snarling at you. That'll be me.
It's strange, because if I get closer, then you can counterattack me, and it's going to be...
Yeah, it's basically who's going to go in for it first, you know? So at the minute, I'm just trying to bring my forces up the field and try and keep everything consolidated so everything can work in concert. I don't want to overextend anything. And with me doing that, it's leaving you going, if I step out, all of a sudden one of my guys is going to get smacked.
So you don't block line of sight, you know, because you're in the rift you're under.
Yes.
1, 2.
Yes, but again, it's that cinematic moment of Achilles is hanging underneath the ledges, waiting for someone. And as soon as someone turns up, he's just going to lift himself out, go in, and go, whap!
I'll do play Athena plus 2 Art of War cards.
Oh, he's going big. All right, so for those of you who don't know, Athena has the strategist ability, which means Leo can now go and hunt for three cards from his deck, any three cards he wants. He will then activate Athena and two of those cards, giving him essentially three activations in the one turn. Are you trying to go for an assassination run on Achilles?
Possibly.
Well, it's the better choice than Cerberus with six wounds versus ten. You know, nearly half the work would be done for you if you go for Achilles. But I suppose with his endurance, that makes life more difficult.
Well, you only score the points, their recruitment points.
Ah, but I'm talking about to actually kill.
Oh, yeah.
So Achilles has six health points, whereas Cerberus has ten.
Yes, but...
So half of the work sort of done with you for Achilles, even though he's more difficult to wound. So I'm wondering what you'll do.
So I have Athena? To start with Athena.
Yes, what will she do?
She will come here.
Okay.
Right. Okay. And I will attack with my owl. Mm-hmm. So my owl has a range of two.
Yes.
One, two. She can attack Cerberus, right?
Okay.
She has four dice. She attacks
Cerberus. She has defense yet.
But if I wonder if I should boost the attack.
Well, if you think you've already spent two out of war cards just to get this attack, so you would really be investing heavily in it. And don't forget, you have a deck which is a lot bigger than mine, so I'm going to be cycling a lot quicker than you.
Which means I will draw the rest of my cards, but my out of war cards are not unlimited. Okay. He's got a defensive eight. Yep. I'll try just like this.
Okay, let's see what we get.
Five, and two plus one.
Yep, so you just need to get one on a die. Yep, so first blood.
First blood. But it's not two. Right, it's whenever you inflict at least two wounds that you add one of these.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. No, does it have to be two on the one go? Yes, or is it two overall?
Two on the one go.
Okay. Okay. So you have two more activations that you can do.
Yeah. One, two. One. Two.
Coming in.
Yes, and they are in the crevasse. Mm-hmm. So now they have a range of one, so they could either attack. No. They will come here. Mm-hmm. They will stop here, not in the crevasse, and they're going to attack Achilles.
Okay, with a range of one.
With a range of one. And they have a plus one because of her.
Because of Athena?
Yes.
Okay.
So instead of rolling four dice, they have five. Mm-hmm. And if I spend one out of war card, they could roll even more.
Defensive nine. And I'll ignore your first wound. Achilles is rock solid on the tabletop, guys. It's not even funny.
Okay, let's try
roll
like
away.
This. Nothing can happen because I can only get 1-5.
Yep, and then roll it and possibly get a 4.
But then you ignore the 4.
Yeah.
Well, right now, because you have your powers, but if there's a token here, you won't have your powers. I should have done that. Mm. I should have... Yes, this is a good way to do. So either I have a better attack, or I make sure you lose your powers.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so nothing. Mm-hmm. And the last one is Minos.
Uh-huh.
Where is he? So he's going to move here.
Yep.
And he's going to attack
Achilles or the Hound?
Achilles. He has a range of one, so he can only attack Achilles. So I'm going first to spend an out of war card.
So you're spending one to put in a swamp token.
Okay.
And that now takes away Achilles' abilities.
Yes, as long as yes.
Okay, I need to get out of that crevasse right now.
And now, when you start your turn in the crevasse, because it has this token, you'll lose 1 point.
Ah, yes. 1 wound. 1 health point automatically. Okay, I need to get Achilles out of there right quick. Or just leave him there and not activate him.
All right, 6 dice.
Yeah.
What is your defense? Is
9.
Well, thank God I did that. Otherwise, it would be impossible even without your powers to wound you. So 5, 6, 7. Still need to roll a 2.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yep. So Achilles will take 1. So.
But that's not enough to put another of these.
No.
Right?
No. It's why I was looking at, you know, tough characters when we were drafting. It was just like, how hard can I make it for Leo to deal wounds?
That's very well done. Yeah. Okay.
So, my turn?
Yes, it's your turn.
Okay, so I'll draw 1.
And when you kill an enemy unit, you immediately gain 1 Omphalos card.
Okay. Okay, so what I need to do is, I'm going to spend 1 Art of War card to search for a specific unit. Because I've just noticed something I can do. There it is, right on the bomb. Every time. Right on the bomb. Every goddamn time. There we go. Okay, so what I was looking for is Zeus.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to activate Zeus. And with his movement of 2, he will go from where he is here. He will go 1 into here, 2 to here.
Sure.
And then from where he is here, I'm going to spend 2 Art of War cards.
Oh, no. I know what you're going to do.
Yep. You've kind of left yourself open for this one, Leo, so I can't.
Oh, no.
I could actually do it from further away because it has a range of 3, but from where I am, 1, 2, and I can hit everything in this one square here with a 9 dice attack.
You haven't activated him, right? So he doesn't lose anything.
No, he doesn't lose anything. It's just straight into this, and he's got range to you here.
Okay. So, well, 9 dice, right?
Yep.
Okay.
It's for all of them. So I'll go with your satyrs first.
Who?
The unit. These guys first.
Okay. Okay, go ahead. Right.
Defense?
Well, the defense is 5, 6 because they're with Athena.
Okay. So let's see what can be done here. So that becomes a 5. There's a 3 with 2 becomes 5. So that goes away, and this becomes a +1. And then I have the Mighty Throw ability, so...
Well, yes, they have 6, right? Yes.
So Mighty Throw will work on these guys as well. So there's 1 dead to start, and then I reroll 2, needing 1. So another 1 dies. So 2 dead.
So 2 dead, that means you can place this anywhere. Well, it has to be adjacent to... But it is.
It is, because you did that. And then this guy... I'm going to throw into the crevasse, which will work nicely. Okay, next target is your Hell Judge. What's his defense?
His defense is 7.
7. Okay, so there's 1, 5. That'll become a 2nd. That's 3. That'll become a 4th. And then with those 2, I will buy 1 automatic wound. And then I will reroll 3.
Oh, 3 or 2?
3 needing 2s.
Did you have 3, really?
Yeah. Oh, well, I had 4 total, so I've built 1 automatic. So I had 4, built 1 automatic, and now I'm rerolling 3 needing 2.
I thought you had 2. Okay.
Maybe wrong. So that's 3 wounds total on him. Does that mean I can do another?
You can put up to 2, because right now 1 is not enough to...
Yeah, actually,
2,
yes. So I will...
1 is enough in here and in here, and you need 2 in here.
Okay, so now there's 2 in here, and now Athena has to take it on the chin as well.
Well, hold on.
Are you going to guard, if you have it?
Well, I can't guard, But I can use my deception talent or power to make you attack. Oh no, this does not work against area or multiple attacks. So no.
So it's okay. Onto Athena for her defensive hit.
Yeah. Yes. Oh.
Okay. So there's four flat to begin with.
Another five.
Another five and another five. And I'm looking for threes on all of these. So threes on six dice.
My god.
Monstrous. So that'll be three wounds on Athena.
Oh gosh. That was really, really bad. So you get another.
Yeah, another one. And it has to connect to that. So what I can actually do is I can put one in here. And if I get another one, I can put it into your deployment zones. Anybody else you bring on the field. They activate the second time, they automatically take a point.
No, you can't put it, well, first, yes, you can't put it on deployment zone. That's
fair enough.
The only way you can do that is by spending an auto war card to do that, right?
Okay.
This is the only way you could put it on the deployment zone.
Okay, so I'll put it somewhere else.
Yes.
All right, well, I will make traveling around the board more difficult for you. I will place it here.
Right now, it's not a big deal, right? It's just a swamp. So
yeah.
But it doesn't take your life points away, right?
Yeah.
Well, that was terrible. It costs you two out of war cards, but they were better used than mine. Okay.
Yeah. But I could still activate a second.
You still haven't scored victory points, have you? No kill.
No, because I haven't
right?
killed anyone yet. So, Cerberus, range zero except for the three head. He has a move of two. No, I'll let you go.
Okay.
That was painful for you.
Very, very painful.
So I spent three out of war cards, but I think I did enough to make it worth it.
I will pay one out of war card to remove this.
Yeah, that's fair enough. So you can do that before you activate and not take the damage. Yep.
And now I should have waited. Shouldn't have come here. That was
Achilles was
with Achilles that I just did. I just did inflict two wounds, right?
That's yeah, it. Yeah. It literally, whenever I placed these two up the field, it was just, can I bait him out? You know, because at that stage, I had the three out of war cards in my hand that I needed to get Zeus out of the deck if I needed to, and then Lightning Bolt. And then I was looking across here going, okay, so if I go 1-2, even if I go 1-2, it's 1-2-3, and I can just launch into whatever's in there.
I'll play Athena. Mm-hmm. I will come back here.
Yeah. Okay.
1-2, do I have any range? No, that's okay. Sorry.
Done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay.
I'm just in a very, very bad situation.
Yeah. All right, so Cerberus has range zero. I'll activate Cerberus. And what Cerberus is going to do is move from here, 1-2, into this space. Place him here. And he will attack the Hell Judge. So, 8 dice.
Have a defense of 7, and is there anybody else you could attack in? No,
no, because it's range 0 and it's just a standard attack.
Okay.
So a 3-headed bite won't work. So, reroll that one. Okay. There's 5 fives.
Again?
What the hell?
No.
I'll keep these as, well, I'll build one automatic and keep a plus 1. So I reroll these, needing, you said 7 or 8?
7.
7, so I need 2s on these. Yep.
Oh my god.
What the hell?
Come on. What is this, Justin? How many did you do?
So I built an automatic, and all 4 of those, so that's 5 wounds on him.
Well, he's dead.
Yarg! think my dice mojo is on par today.
He's worth 3 points, so you score 3 victory points, and you can put
yes. I will place it here just to give you some problems.
Okay.
I'm going to give you these dice. Just take them away from me because this looks horrible.
Oh, there's one here, right?
Yes.
Right now you're not affected, but...
No. But now there are two up here. So this zone anybody that clambers into is going to have to deal with it.
And this one is already infected, right?
That's the reason I haven't activated Achilles yet. I'm hoping you'll... I'm actually just going to leave the satyr here. Because as soon as you activate it, it takes a point. It dies, I gain a VP. So it neuters one unit.
Well, you could kill him and
I don't
also
need to.
Score.
I don't need to, because if you kill him, you can then recall him.
Yeah, and if you activate Achilles, you lose
one. Take one, well, yeah. But I'm waiting to activate Achilles until he has somewhere to go, something to do.
Okay. I'm going to put one of these here. Mm-hmm. Next time you activate
Cerberus, he will take one. Yep, and all of his abilities no longer work because he has the two on him.
Yeah. Right.
Yep. That's unfortunate.
And I'm going to deploy Leonidas.
Mm-hmm.
He's a protector.
Oh. Yeah, so he has... Or do you need to? Because you already have your other Death Judge there.
Yeah, so... Yeah, still. Yes, I
okay.
Do. All right, your turn. My God, I'm defensive. I tried to attack you and... The retaliation was terrible.
It was one of those things where it was just like, oh my sweet lord. Right, so now that I have you on the back foot, I have some time to actually bring in the last of my forces. So I will play Odysseus and deploy him. So Odysseus will just deploy back here in my deployment zone. Happy as light. And where is... playing shell games with the tokens.
And I only have one call left.
Yep. Yeah, That will do me.
I will deploy the centaurs.
Mm-hmm.
Bringing back forces.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Your turn.
Okay. I draw. My hounds. Yeah, cry havoc and let's slip the dogs of war. So I'll play the hellhounds. They have a move of 2.
Mm-hmm. And they can go in the in the crevasse.
So they will actually be going for a run. So one here, two here, and the third two here. They will go right up with Cerberus.
Well, now they don't have their powers, and next time they activate here, they lose one hound.
If I don't spend the Art of War card to remove it.
Oh.
You need to worry about me. I'm getting tactical with this.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is it my turn?
Yes.
I will deploy the Hell Warriors.
Okay.
Well, everybody's here now.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody but Minus.
Yes, who is dead? Gone buried.
Okay, your turn.
My turn. Okay, I will spend one Art of War card to search for a card from my deck. There you are. I am going to activate Cerberus, so he will take a point of damage.
Oh.
Because I haven't been able to get rid of that.
Where's he going?
He's going nowhere. He's going to stand where he is. Spend an Art of War card and go for a Blazing Breath attack.
You can't do that.
Look. No. Ah, oh, yeah. So I have to move first.
You have to move first, or you have to spend an Art of War card to remove one of
those.
So I
can go here and here. And then I'm in the clear.
Or you can go here.
All right, I thought this was a...
No. This is just a normal area. These are just a cliff.
Yeah, I'll go to there for handiness. So now I've got clear line of sight, I've got my ability.
But
back.
we can't put swamp tokens here because it's upper, here, here, right?
Ah, okay.
You see?
Okay.
And here. Over there.
Okay, but now I've spent the Art of War card, so I do the Blazing Breath attack into your deployment zone, which is a 6 dice attack, target all enemy units in a single area adjacent to Cerberus.
Is it a 6 dice attack?
The white one, so it's
oh,
6.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you're right. Oh, gosh. Okay, so who do you start with?
Who has guard?
The centaurs have guard. He has guard. He has guard. Well, they all have guard.
Okay, I will start with the centaurs.
Okay.
Will you guard?
I don't guard.
Will you guard a guard?
No, no. Well, I could. I technically could. Yeah. But, okay, so well, they've got 6 plus 1 because they're in Athena's area, so it's 7.
7. Okay.
What are they?
So that's 4 becomes, okay, 5.
Well,
I reroll. 7. Needing 2s.
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yes. so that'll be 3.
All right.
So they're dead.
They're dead.
And another VP. The next attack will be on the Hell Warriors.
You can have a...
Yes, I get one of those. I'll put one in here just in case you try to run away.
Okay, so who's the next target?
Next target will be the Hell Warriors.
Don't guard.
Defense of...
Defense of 5 plus 1, 6.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait. They have got 6 plus 1, 7. Because there are at least 3 warriors. 7. Okay. 7.
So that'll be 2 with a plus 1. That's more average for the rolls you get. That'll be 2 dead.
Oh, still.
Yeah.
All right. So, well, another of these.
Yeah. I'll place it in here.
Okay.
It's connected.
Yeah.
Then Leonidas.
I will deflect to the... Oh. Then you would score a victory point, right?
Possibly. AoEs in this are very powerful if your opponent has been forced, like Leo here, just to back up.
I'm not.
Just on Leo? Or yeah. Just
he's got 7.
Okay. So defense?
7.
Okay. So that will become 2 5s.
And a plus 1.
And mighty throw.
Yes.
That'll be 2 wounds.
2 wounds?
Yep, 2 wounds. And I will throw you from here into the crevasse. So the next time you activate, he'll take an additional point. Then lastly, it's
well,
your Death Judge is next.
Yes.
And then, oh yeah, I still have to do Athena. But you can see what I'm doing. I'm trying to get everyone with guard first. So you either have to choose, am I giving you a victory point, or can Athena take another hit? So on the Hell Judge, defense?
7.
7s, okay.
Oh, you don't throw them. That's a poor roll for once.
Yes. So that, plus that becomes 2 rerolls and a plus 1.
Just yeah, one.
Just the one wound.
Finally! Bad roll.
I don't know. Sometimes the dice mojo is just there. So lastly, on Athena, I assume you're guarding.
I'm guarding.
On to?
Ickes.
Ickes. Okay, so needing 7 again.
7, so.
So that's 2.
And a...
By an automatic. And a reroll 1, needing a 2. Yep, so that's 2 more wounds.
Oh.
And so I will place one of these here, sort of box it in a little more.
Oh yes, now if I activate him, he loses 1 point.
Yes. Right?
Oh god. Okay.
So.
Well, thank you, Justin. Thank you.
Again, that was somebody good. Calls me Jason.
Okay.
I have been a little bit vicious this game.
No. Well, you've understood better than I did. Well, it's actually the first time I played this scenario. It's been played by, so this I'm trying to remember. But you need, it's very technical, you need to think about it, and I just realized I've played poorly. And you have done well, but that's good, that's good. Mm-hmm. Let me, okay, my turn.
Yes, your turn. Or is it? Yeah, it is.
And even my draft, I should have taken bigger beast. Stronger power.
My thinking is you probably thought I'll be nipping in and through the crevasses a lot more.
Yeah. I'll draw two cards.
Uh-huh.
To spend another war card to remove this.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to move Leonidas
yeah.
back here.
Yeah.
And I'm going to attack. So I didn't lose
Yep, because you spent the art war before, yep.
And I'm going to attack the Hellhounds.
The Hellhounds, okay.
So.
Defense of four.
I have the Phalanx talent, which means I would get a plus one attack and defense if I was with a full unit, which is not the case. I mean, the Hell Warriors.
Took a lump, yeah.
So I only get a six dice, but... The dogs are not that strong.
Yeah, there are six of them, and it's on fours. So there should be a few dead here.
There's a chance I can do something.
Yeah?
Well, at least one, two... Three are dead, right?
Three are dead.
It's not too bad.
So half the unit goes.
And I get one of these.
Yes. There's already two on here. There's one in here, one in here.
Two on here, okay.
You could put one onto Zeus's zone. Mm-hmm. Actually make him start to move a bit.
Even though it wouldn't wound him because he would need another one, right?
Maybe so, but it means that I have to look at it and say, okay, Leo might put another one there if he does more damage.
No, well.
Okay.
Okay, your turn.
Okay, I will draw.
It will be a miracle if I win this game.
right.
You have four victory points, right?
Yeah, I'm halfway there. So I will activate Zeus. And Zeus is going to go for a little stroll. Here one. Here two. Right to the edge of the map.
Okay.
Because then he's up and away from that water. And I think still one, two, three. If I really need to, I can get the dogs out of the way here and clear line of sight.
Sure.
So that'll do for me. Your turn.
Okay, well, I will pass and just draw one card in that case.
That is a nice thing to be able to do if you have something that you just do not want to have to do something. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw two with an Art of War card, just so that I can fill my hand a little, because it's getting quite empty. I'll then activate Odysseus, he's just been hanging out at the back, watching everybody have fun. So he's going to run. So, from where he is in here, he can go one to here, and two to here, which would be okay. And at the end of his activation, I get to draw one. There's no one in his zone, so he can't activate anyone else, but that's okay, he's getting up and into the mix. So, your turn, Leo.
Well, I want you to score 8-0. I want to save the honor. Is there anything in here? Oh, yes.
Yes, the pops are there.
I don't have a ranged attack. I could be in trouble. Okay. Well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to prevent Cerberus from entering this area and attacking us.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to use... him.
Mm-hmm.
Ekus.
Yep.
He's going to move here and attack Cerberus.
Okay, good choice.
He has the ability, well, Jailer of the Underworld. Enemy units must pay one Art of War card to leave his area.
Yes.
So
okay.
It's going to be complicated for you because you don't have that many left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I could have come here, but then that means I was next time I activated.
Taking the wound, yep.
What's his defense?
Eight.
Still.
Tough. Ooh, that's good.
That's a little better. So two, three fives.
Yep.
And two plus ones, right?
Yeah.
One, five, six, seven, eight.
Two wins.
Oh, not bad.
Good hit. And that now takes his attack down. Seven.
And
his defense,
I can put
seven.
His defense.
And you
is,
can place a swamp token.
Of course, I'm going to put it
on
here.
On Odysseus, yeah. I figured as much. I was hoping I would be fit to sneak through there. done?
Done.
Okay, so Zeus activates. He will walk. Just the one to get to here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll do. One to here. And from here, he's got a clear line, the lightning bolt in here.
Okay.
I kid you not. I literally just top decked the second to last art war card.
Oh my god. Okay, well.
Nine dice.
So six is it still not? Oh, yeah.
He hasn't taken any damage, so.
How many do you need?
Six more.
Okay, who do you start with?
Hell Warriors. Let's get them out of the way. Defense?
Oh, wait, I could. No.
Would you like
the
guard?
Point? No.
Okay. Hell Warriors.
Hell Warriors, their defense now is. They're not three anymore, so it's only five plus plus one is six because of the presence.
There's two.
Okay, well, that
becomes three. Yeah, I can just build the two that I need.
So you score another point.
Yep. So I'm on five.
Well, you could just put it on five, right?
I find it easier to cut the other way.
Okay. Oh yeah, to go to L2 to
go
eight.
Four and four.
Yeah. And you get a swamp token.
Yeah, I'll just pop it back in here just in case somebody gets thrown. I'll go for Achilles, or Leonidas, who is here because he's your only guard.
Yeah.
If I get lucky and throw him.
He's got seven.
Yep. So not that and that. That goes to two more rerolls. One automatic and a plus one, and a mighty throw. Because he's just, is he a big size or human size?
Human size.
So one would mighty throw him as well. So there's a plus one there. I said one automatic and a reroll two. So that becomes seven. Seven, so three wins. And I send him flying into here.
And you get one.
And swamp token in here. Athena.
God. She's got a defense of seven.
Defense seven. Okay. So four becomes five to reroll with two plus ones. That's lost. So five to reroll, needing twos. And actually, one of them becomes an automatic with the two plus ones. Four to reroll becomes three wounds on Athena total. Ow.
Two lightning bolts.
Yeah, into reasonably packed squares.
Yeah. Okay, well, now you close. If I draw the good card, at least I can attack you, but
yeah.
You are tough. You haven't even lost anything, right?
No, I'm on defense nine, full health. Your forces are looking beat down and battered to hell. How many wins does Leonidas have left? Just the one?
Just one.
So
if I activate him here, he's dead.
Yeah. And, yeah, it's tough.
Okay. Draw a card.
Yeah.
What, not the best one I could draw. okay.
You could take the moral victory and say, no, Leonidas, you have failed me. Just push his head down into the River Styx.
Oh, gosh. All right. You know what?
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing I really can do. If I activate him, he's dead. If I activate him, he's dead. The centaurs are not there. I need another war card to bring them back.
Yeah.
So I will pass and draw one card.
Okay. So I'll draw my one. Okay, I'm going to activate Odysseus, because I don't need to worry about him taking a single wound. Just take that on the chin. He will activate from here with his speed of 1. Actually, yeah, he'll go for a run, 1-2. Oh no, he'll just walk to here for 1. Because I want to draw this last card now that his activation is done. Yeah. And then he can activate someone else, but there's no one in his space, so it's back to you, Leo.
And you didn't draw again, so I don't get my last card. Okay. Our warriors are dead too.
But on your turn, I may as well shuffle this, if that's okay with you.
Sure, sure. Well, let's try to score at least 1 point, if I can.
I feel really bad now.
You know, my owl is dead. I can't even throw it.
No?
Yes.
Oh, God. This is going to be a bad beat story for a while.
Well, I can use these as an auto war card, right?
Yep.
Because he's dead.
Yes. Because he's a hero and not a unit.
Yes.
Yep.
And now you're going to get some more cards.
Yeah, I'm about to get a boost to my hand of 4.
So I'm going to just attack what I can. So either Zeus, but he's got a defensive 9.
Cerberus. Is on 7.
I will go on Cerberus.
Cerberus is on 7, so he is weakening.
Okay, let's try.
Yeah, may as well. See what we get.
And here, you don't risk losing your powers.
Yeah.
Your
It's a good place.
It is. Okay, so 2 5s. Right?
Yeah, you can build 1 automatic.
Yes, I'll build 1 automatic and reroll 1 and have a +1, right?
Yes. So Cerberus loses 1.
Yes, 2nd.
2 more.
2 more.
Okay, so he's down to 6 attack, 7 defense. The big dog's weakening. Okay.
Okay.
So I draw 1, 2, 3 because I've had to reshuffle my deck. And then an additional because it's my turn.
Okay, so
now you get all of yours.
I get all of your mine plus 3 cards, right?
Yep.
So I reshuffle.
So let's finish this with a bang. Zeus with lightning.
Again? Oh no! No! Oh no!
From here, he will just lightning Leonidas.
Yes, that's right. You can see.
Yep.
Yes, that's right.
Because I think that's the easiest way to end this.
Absolutely, yes. Okay.
So, 6 more dice.
6 more dice. Hate to hear that.
Okay, Leo's defense now.
He's 5. Come on, think you can make it.
1 5 on 9. If I don't make this, something's badly wrong. Yeah, he's dead. Thrice over, he's dead.
Gosh.
Good game, mate.
That was a beating.
Well, it's going to be a bad beat story for a time. I went for a very aggressive force.
The worst defeat in my life. Wow. Well, 8-0, right?
Let's look at it this way. Benoit will be overjoyed. He will watch this every night before he goes to sleep going, yes, he lost.
Well, congratulations. You did well.
That was a good game. I really enjoyed that. I feel bad because that was quite the steamroller. I got very lucky with a lot of my rolls, I have to say.
Yeah,
the number of 5s I was rolling up there, that's way above the odds, guys. But it was fun. It was funny. Get your comments in below. We will see you in the next one.
We hope you enjoyed this Let's Play. Go ahead and check out our other content on screen now, and be sure to check out beastsofwar.com for the latest gaming news and gaming Let's Plays. And while you're at it, why not hit subscribe and remember to ding our dong. Go on, you know you want to click it. Go on.